36, Marilyn Monroe died of a barbiturate overdose. Whether suicide or an accident is still not known. Regardless, she is still a superstar. The mention of her name evokes the vivid image of the young Monroe. And a quarter of a century later, her image still makes money for those who exploit her. Today, in the first of a special three-part report, we'll explore her magic as it extends from the billboards of Times Square to a quiet cemetery in Westwood, California.
Figure would stop traffic when she was 50.
Her vulnerability.
She knew what to do with what
so
she
we see ourselves
had gone.
In her.
Drugs, not hard.
Harlow is Marilyn.
Which was in the bloodstream.
It happened almost 25 years ago.
Do anything high.
Hollywood and Vine.
What happens when you get there?
What happens, honey? You get discovered. You get tested with options and everything.
You're 25 years?
I was 14 years old.
And you cried and cried?
I heard it on the news, and I cried my eyes out.
Well, pretty lady, you are what dreams are made of.
A lot of people were not alive when Humphrey Bogart said goodbye to Ingrid Bergman in Casablanca, but once you see it, you can't forget it. Once you've seen Marilyn Monroe, you never forget her.
A kiss on the hand may be quite continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend. A kiss.
The public is still enchanted with her, and she's a very active part of the fantasy of this generation, which has to be, you know, two or three generations since she died. And that's a very powerful impression to make on the world.
And we all lose our chance in the end.
I'm not sure if it was suicide or was it an accident, but she always had the pills there.
Well, the pills are there because the people are insecure themselves. Most show people are very insecure.
When she was doing Asphalt Jungle, she had gotten somebody to research who her father was. And she had this number, and it was like someplace in Whittier or something like that. And she called this number, and it was quite late, and a man answered and said, yeah? And said, look, I don't know whether you know me. I'm Marilyn Monroe. I've been getting a lot of publicity, but my mother says that you're my father. And he said, listen, you little tramp, don't you ever call my house again. I've got my own family. Don't you ever call here. I'm nobody to you. And hung up. Madonna does a pretty good imitation of her, but it's an imitation.
Like a fantastic character in a novel.
Forget the imperfections of Marilyn Monroe.
Her career started going down.
Maybe she represents the good times. Maybe she represents what sex seemed to be fun.
Oh, I was about that, right? Yes.
When he was in Hollywood?
Yes, I was sitting with Judy Garland. Khrushchev, who was very busy being political about Disneyland, they wouldn't let him go to Disneyland, about America's position, just stopped everything and stopped and talked to her for the longest while with his interpreter and his eyes. Mm-hmm. I think Judy Garland said, she's not going to have an affair with Khrushchev, is she? Or something like that. I said, no.
The world might have been better off if they had. Who knows?
Stop it.
Gloria Steinem's bestseller, Marilyn, is one of more than 40 books written about Monroe. That's just one measure of the public's fascination with her story. Tomorrow, we'll see how merchandisers have cashed in on that interest.